čitat ćemo iz druge Korinćanima poslanice, četvrtu glavu, whole chapter.
Ja, that's okay.
Zato imajući ovu službu, kao što bismo pomilovani, ne dosađuje nam se, nego se odrekusmo tajnoga srama da ne živimo u lukavstvu, niti da izvrćemo reč Božiju, nego javljanjem istine da se pokažemo svakoj savesti čovečije pred Bogom. Ako li je pak pokriveno evanđelje naše, u onima je pokriveno koji ginu, u kojima Bog sveta ovoga oslepi razume nevernika, da im ne zasvetli videlo evanđelja slave Hristove koji je obličje Boga koji se ne vidi. Jer sebe ne propovedamo, nego Hrista Isusa Gospoda, a sebe same vaše sluge Isusa Gospoda radi. Jer Bog koji reče da iz tame zasvetli videlo, zasvetli u srcima našima na svetlost poznanja slave Božije u licu Isusa Hrista. Ali ovo blago imamo u zemljanim sudovima da premnoštvo sile bude od Boga, a ne od nas. U svemu imamo nevolje, ali nam ne dosađuje. Zbunjeni smo, ali ne gubimo nada. Progone nas, ali nismo ostavljeni. Obaljuju nas, ali ne ginemo. I jednako nosimo na telu smrt Gospoda Isusa, da se život Isusov na telu našemu pokaže. Jer mi živi, jednako se predajemo na smrt za Isusa, da se i život Isusov javi na smrtnome telu našemu. Zato dakle smrt vlada u nama, a život u vama. Imajući pak onaj isti duh vere kao što je napisano verovah, zato govorih, mi verujemo i zato govorimo. Znajući da će onaj koji podiže Isusa i nas podignuti sa Isusom i postaviti s vama. Jer je sve radi vas, da blagodat umnožena izobiluje hvalama na slavu Božiju. Zato nam se ne dosađuje, no ako se naš spoljašni čovjek i raspada, ali se unutrašnji obnavlja svaki dan. Jer naša laka sadašnja briga donosi nam večnu i od svega pretežniju slavu. Nama koji ne gledamo na ovo što se vidi, nego na ono što se ne vidi, jer je ovo što se vidi za vreme, a ono što se ne vidi večno.
This letter from which we have just read,
ovo pismo iz kog smo upravo pročitali odlomak,
was written by Paul to a church which he himself had been involved in planting.
Je napisana od strane Pavla crkvi u kojoj je sam on učestvovao da se zasadi.
But this church in Corinth had been strongly influenced by people who rejected Paul's authority as an apostle.
Ali ova crkva u Korintu je bila pod jakim uticajem ljudi koji su odbijali Pavlov autoritet.
People who had distorted the gospel message.
Ljudi koji su pokvarili poruku evanđelja.
Paul had already challenged the false teaching that was happening in Corinth, both in person and in writing.
Pavle je već izazvao to pogrešno učenje koje se pojavilo u Korintu, i lično, a i kroz pisanje.
And in this particular letter he writes to encourage faithful believers to stand for the truth.
A ovo specifično pismo on piše da bi ohrabrio prave vernike da zauzmu čvrst stav za istinu.
He writes to encourage them to defend the authenticity of the gospel message he proclaimed.
Piše im da bi ih pozvao da brane autentičnog svetog pisma i autentičnost evanđelja uopšte.
So I want to share just a few of those challenges and encouragements with you this morning.
Zato bih hteo da podelim sa vama par ovih izazova i ohrabrenja ovoga jutra.
And so as we look at this chapter, there are three main things I want to notice. The first is this.
Dogledamo ovo poglavlje, hteo bih da specifično pogledamo u tri dela. Prvo je ovo.
The first challenge, keep gospel truth central in everything.
Prvi izazov je drži istinu evanđelja centralno postavljenu u svim stvarima.
I think there are three reasons why this is important.
Postoji tri razloga zbog čega je ovo bitno.
Firstly, the devil will try to present the church with pleasing alternatives to the biblical gospel.
Prvo, đavo će pokušati da predstavi crkvu sa umoljavajućim alternativama evanđeoskoj crkvi. Dakle, postojaće neke druge alternative, samo da nije crkva evanđeoska.
We live in a world where the concept of truth is under attack.
Mi živimo u svetu gde je koncept istine pod napadom.
Especially the truth of the gospel.
Specifično istina evanđelja.
Because the gospel makes exclusive and uncompromising claims upon our lives.
Zato što evanđelje čini ekskluzivno, beskompromisno uticanje na naše živote, uticaj na naše živote.
The devil's temptation is to make our message more popular.
Đavolja kušnja je da načini našu poruku da bude popularnija.
And to increase those who come to church.
Da uveća samo broj onih koji dolaze u crkvu.
By exchanging the powerful truth of the gospel for something else.
Zamenjujući pravu istinu evanđelja za nešto drugo, atraktivnije.
Something different than the gospel.
Nešto drugačije od evanđelja.
This is what had happened in Corinth.
Ovo je ono što se desilo u Korintu.
And so Paul writes here in verse 2.
Tako da Pavle piše ovdje u stihu 2.
We have renounced disgraceful underhand ways. We refuse to practice cunning or to tamper with God's word.
Odrekao smo se tajnoga srama, dakle prestali smo da se igramo sa Božijom rečju, da izazivamo Boga igrajući se sa njegovom rečju.
But by the open statement of the truth, we would commend ourselves to everyone's conscience in the sight of God.
Nego sa otvorenom istinom evanđelja mi se predstavljamo svima i svačijoj savesti ispred Gospoda.
Tampering with the truth doesn't begin with huge heresy.
Igranje sa istinom ne počinje sa nekim ogromnom neistinom.
But just little by little adapting the message to make it sound less challenging.
Nego malo po malo prilagođava se poruka da bi bila manje izazovna.
So people will talk a lot about coming to Jesus for eternal life.
Tako da će ljudi puno govoriti o tome dođi Hristu za večni život.
But talk little about the need to repent of sin.
Ali govoriti jako malo o potrebi pokajanja za greh.
They will talk much about the blessings of Christian discipleship, but little about the cost or the sacrifice involved in following Jesus.
Puno toga će govoriti o blagoslovima hrišćanstva, ali će veoma malo govoriti o tim teškim mestima gdje se treba žrtvovati za Hrista.
Perhaps they speak a lot about heaven, but never about hell.
Govore mnogo o nebu, ali nikada o paklu.
They speak about the blessing of forgiveness, but say little about personal holiness.
Govore mnogo o blagoslovima oproštenja, ali malo govore o ličnoj pobožnosti i svetosti.
And so little by little the devil takes us away from the full truth of God's word.
Tako da malo po malo đavo nas odvaja od pune istine Božje reči.
So let us beware of alternatives to the fullness of gospel truth.
Budimo svesni alternativa koje su nasuprot punoće božanske istine.
Secondly, let us keep gospel truth central because we can be easily sidetracked by other things.
Druga stvar je, držimo istinu evanđelja centralnom zato što nam je lako da se skliznemo u druge neke stvari.
In my country, in Britain,
u Britaniji, u mojoj, u Ireland, u mojoj državi,
many churches are busy places, lots of things are happening, and the bigger the church becomes, the more activity there is.
Mnoge crkve su zauzete svojim stvarima koje rade, mnogo je aktivnosti, mnogo je ljudi, i što je veća crkva, sve više i više aktivnosti uključeno u crkvu.
Something is happening every day of the week.
Nešto se dešava svakog dana tokom nedelje.
But whether our church is big or small, we always need to ask this question.
Bila naša crkva velika ili mala, mi uvijek treba da pitamo ovo pitanje.
Is everything we do for the advancement of the gospel?
Da li je sve što radimo za napredak evanđelja?
Sometimes when churches grow bigger, they become focused on running lots and lots of program in the church.
Nekada kada crkva postane velika, oni su toliko fokusirani da vode neke programe, razne programe uvezano za crkvu.
But they forget that outside the church there is a community, many of whom know nothing of the gospel.
Ali zaboravljaju da u crkvi postoji zajednica, da postoje mnogi koji van crkve postoji zajednica mnogih koji ne znaju ništa o evanđelju. To zaboravljaju.
People who are spiritually lost and dying in their sin.
Ljudi koji su duhovno izgubljeni i koji umiru u svojim gresima.
When Paul speaks about people who are outside of Christ, he uses some strong words.
Kada Pavle govori o ljudima koji su van Hrista, on koristi neke jako teške reči.
He says they are perishing. They are blinded. They cannot see the light.
Kaže da oni nestaju, oni su zaslepljeni, oni ne mogu videti svetlo.
That is the problem with so many people in my community. I expect it's the same problem in yours.
Tako, to je problem sa mnogim ljudima u njegovoj zajednici, misleći na kulturnu zajednicu naroda oko njega, i veruje da je isti taj problem i kod nas.
I am so pleased to see your church with new premises. It's growing, it's getting bigger. That's really good. That's God's blessing.
Thank you. Drago mu je da vidi nove stvari u našoj crkvi koje su obećavajuće, koje pokazuju Božji blagoslov i Božji napredak, i to je zaista Božji blagoslov. Drago mu je zbog toga.
But we always must always remember, no matter how many good things are happening here in church, we don't forget the reaching out of the gospel to lost people.
Ne smemo zaboraviti da posežemo za ljudima koji su izgubljeni, da dosežemo ih evanđeljem, bez obzira koliko se dobre stvari dešavaju u našoj zajednici.
So we keep gospel truth central, firstly, because Satan tempts us with alternatives to the gospel.
Prva stvar zašto držimo centralno tu poruku evanđelja, zato što nas Satana kuša i sa alternativama evanđelja, sa nekim omekšanim evanđeljem.
Secondly, because we become easily sidetracked by other things.
Druga stvar, zato što se veoma lako zamajemo nekim drugim stvarima.
Thirdly, we keep the gospel central because nothing else has the power to change people's lives for eternity.
Treća stvar jeste to, držimo se glavne poruke evanđelja, jer ništa drugo nema silu da promeni ljudske živote i da im daruje večni život.
In verse 4 of this chapter, Paul speaks of how Satan, the god of this age, has blinded the minds of unbelievers.
U četvrtom stihu Pavle kaže kako je Satana, bog ovoga sveta, oslepio razumne nevernike da ne mogu razumeti ni videti evanđelje.
He has blinded them so they cannot see the light of the gospel of the glory of Christ.
Oslepio ih je tako da ne mogu da vide blagoslove evanđelja i slavu Gospoda Isusa Hrista.
But he adds these words in verses 5 and 6.
Ali dodaje ove reči u 5. i 6. stihu.
What we proclaim is not ourselves, but Jesus Christ as Lord. Ourselves, your servants, for Jesus' sake.
Jer sebe ne propovedamo, nego Gospoda Isusa Hrista, a sebe same gledamo kao da smo sluge vaše radi Isusa Hrista, Gospoda.
For God who said, let light shine out of darkness, has shone in our hearts to give the light of the knowledge of the glory of God in the face of Christ.
Jer Bog koji reče da iz tame zasvetli videlo, zasvetli u srcima našim na svetlost poznanja slave Božije u licu Isusa Hrista.
The answer to the spiritual darkness of lost humanity is to preach Jesus Christ as Lord.
Odgovor za slepoću izgubljenog čovečanstva jeste propovedati Isusa Hrista kao Gospoda.
Because that is what God uses.
Jer to je ono što Bog koristi.
By his miraculous power to shine his light into our darkness.
Svojom veličanstvenom silom da zasija svoje svetlo u našu tamu.
We remember how in Romans chapter 1 Paul says that the gospel is the power of God for the salvation of everyone who believes.
Sećamo se kako u Rimljanima 1 Pavle kaže da je evanđelje sila na spasenje svakome koji veruje.
Nothing else provides deliverance from sin and darkness and spiritual death.
Ništa drugo ne obezbeđuje izlazak od sile tame, od sile greha i od sile smrti.
So we keep the gospel central in everything.
Tako da se držimo poruke evanđelja, glavne poruke evanđelja u svemu.
That is the first priority.
To je prvi prioritet, to je broj jedan u prioritetima.
The second thing I want us to see in this chapter is this.
Druga stvar koju hoću da vidimo u ovom poglavlju jeste ovo.
Make your weakness available to God.
Postaraj se da svoje slabosti budu dostupne Gospodu, da tvoje slabosti budu dostupne Gospodu.
That might sound an unusual thing to say.
Možda može to zvučiti čudno da se kaže tako.
Perhaps I should be saying, make your talents, make your gifts available to God.
Možda bi trebao reći, postavi da tvoji talenti, tvoji darovi budu dostupni Gospodu.
And that would not be a wrong thing to say.
I to ne bi bilo pogrešno reći.
Every Christian has both natural abilities given to them by God.
Svaki hrišćanin ima one prirodne sposobnosti koje su mu date od Gospoda.
And also special spiritual gifts to serve the life of Christ's church.
I isto tako posebne duhovne darove kojima bi trebao da služi životu crkve.
But in the context of what Paul says in 2 Corinthians 4 and in other parts of this letter,
ali u kontekstu Pavlovog pisma 2. Korinćane 4 i drugim delovima ovoga pisma,
I want to say to you and I say to myself,
želim da kažem vama kao i sebi,
make your weakness available to God.
Učinite da vaše slabosti budu dostupne Gospodu.
For Paul, the key to effective gospel witness is God's power in our weakness.
Jer Pavlov ključ za efektivno dosezanje evanđeljem jeste Božja sila u našoj slabosti.
Look what he says in verse 7.
Pogledajte šta kaže u stihu 7.
But we have this treasure in jars of clay to show that the surpassing power belongs to God and not to us.
Ali ovo blago imamo u zemljanim sudovima, da premnoštvo sile bude od Boga, a ne od nas.
What is the treasure?
Šta je blago?
It is the gospel of the glory of Christ.
To je evanđelje slave Hristove.
The most precious, life-changing message that could ever be communicated.
Najdragocenija poruka koja jedino može da dovede do promene.
And what are the jars of clay?
A šta su te posude, zemljane posude?
People like you, people like me, and every other Christian who has the good news of Jesus to tell.
Ljudi kao vi, čovjek kao ja i svi ostali ljudi kojima treba biti rečena istina evanđelja.
In New Testament times, clay jars were common containers.
U vreme Novog Zaveta te zemljane posude su bile glavne posude za odlaganje stvari.
They were used to hold and to carry all kinds of things.
Bile su korišćene da zadržavaju ili da se nosi u njima razno razne stvari. Vino, voda, wine, water.
Yeah, just like today we have plastic boxes and plastic bags for the same purpose.
Kao danas što imamo plastične kutije ili plastične kese za iste te stvari.
But the clay jar wasn't an especially attractive thing.
I ta zemljana posuda nije nešto bila specifično privlačna.
And it was fragile, it could easily break.
I bila je jako lomljiva.
It wasn't the place where you might store very valuable jewelry or gold coins.
Nije bilo nešto u što biste mogli želeli da stavite nešto veoma vredno, kao što su zlatni novčići ili neki dragulji.
For those things you might have a special box that locked and was secure.
Za takve stvari imali biste posebnu kutiju koja bi mogla bude zaključana i osigurana.
But Paul's point here is this. God has entrusted the gospel not to just a few special people.
Ali Pavlova glavna poruka ovdje jeste da Bog nije evanđelje poverio samo nekolicini specifičnih i specijalnih ljudi.
God does not simply entrust the gospel to people who have amazing talent, incredible personality, dynamic presentation.
Bog nije dao tu poruku evanđelja samo onima koji imaju izvanrednu ličnost, koji su dinamični u svom govoru, koji mogu da prezentuju stvari nekako euforično.
He entrusts the gospel to ordinary people through whom he can work and he can show his power despite our weakness.
Poverio je istinu evanđelja običnim ljudima kroz koje može da pokaže svoju silu i svoju slavu kroz ljude koji nisu nešto posebno, nisu nešto specijalno, koji imaju svoje slabosti.
I think that this is something I have sometimes struggled with in Christian ministry.
Ovo je nešto sa čim ja lično se borim u hrišćanskoj službi.
Perhaps I hear about something that is happening in another church.
Nekada možda čujem za neke stvari koje se dešavaju u nekoj drugoj crkvi.
The other church seems to be amazing.
Druga crkva se deluje kao da je izvanredna.
They have lots of programs of different kinds.
Imaju dosta različitih programa.
Their pastor seems amazing.
Njihov pastor deluje izvanredno.
He has unlimited strength and stamina.
Ima neograničenu snagu.
How do I feel?
Kako se ja osjećam?
I get a little bit envious.
Ja nekad postanem malo ljubomoran, zavidan.
Yeah, and then I get discouraged.
Onda postanem bezohrabren.
And I think my church and my work are so different from all of that.
I kažem moj rad i moja crkva je skroz drugačija od svega toga.
But maybe I haven't heard the whole story about that other church.
Ali možda ja nisam čuo celu priču o toj drugoj crkvi.
It probably has its own problems.
Verovatno ima svoje probleme.
And that other pastor?
I taj drugi pastor?
Maybe he boasts about his work more than he ought to.
Možda se bije u prsa za svoju poruku više nego što bi trebao.
And he talks about his church more than he ought to.
I možda govori više o svojoj crkvi nego što bi trebao.
So when I feel a little bit discouraged and down,
tako da kada se ja osjetim malo obeshrabrenim i malo poniženim, malo da sam dole,
I need to get my eyes away from that other church and that other pastor.
Moram usmeriti svoj pogled na drugu stranu od tog, od te druge crkve i tog drugog pastora.
And I need to come back to what Paul says to the Corinthians.
I moram da se vratim ka onome što Pavle kaže Korinćanima.
Here he talks about how he felt hard pressed, perplexed, persecuted, struck down.
Ovdje piše kako se on osjećao kada je bio pritisnut, kada je bio pritišnjen, kada je bio udaran i kada je se osjećao da je totalno nisko.
Paul says gospel work is very difficult for all kinds of reasons.
Pavle kaže rad evanđelja je težak iz mnogih različitih razloga.
In his first letter to the Corinthians in chapter 2,
u prvom pismu u Korinćanima u drugom stihu,
he says this in verse 1.
On kaže ovo u prvom stihu.
When I came to you, brothers,
kada sam vam došao, braćo,
I did not come with superior wisdom,
nisam došao sa superiornijom mudrošću,
as I proclaimed to you the testimony about God,
dok sam vam propovedao svjedočanstvo Božije.
For I resolved to know nothing while I was with you except Jesus Christ and him crucified.
Ja odlučio sam da ne znam ništa među vama osim Isusa Hrista i to razapetoga.
I came to you in weakness and fear.
Došao sam među vas u slabosti i strahu.
And with much trembling.
I sa mnogim drhtanjem.
My message, my preaching were not with wise and persuasive words.
Moja poruka, moje razgovori nisu bili sa visokim ubeđujućim rečenicama.
But with a demonstration of the Spirit's power.
Nego sa demonstracijom duhovne sile.
So that your faith might not rest on men's wisdom, but on God's power.
Tako da se vaša vera ne oslanja na čovečansku mudrost, nego na Božju silu.
The American pastor and writer John Piper.
Američki pastor i pisac John Piper.
Has written a book about Christian ministry.
Je napisao knjigu o hrišćanskoj službi.
In that book he has a chapter with an unusual title.
U toj knjizi ima poglavlje sa neobičnim naslovom.
He says this, brothers, tell them not to serve God.
Kaže ovako, braćo, nemojte im reći da služe Bogu.
What does he mean?
Šta misli kroz to?
Because we always want to encourage people to serve God.
Mi uvijek hoćemo da ohrabrimo ljude da služe Bogu.
But he's thinking about Paul's words spoken in Athens in Acts chapter 17.
Ali on dok to govori misli o Pavlovim riječima koje je rekao u Atini u Delima apostolskim trećem poglavlju.
Where Paul says God is not served by human hands as if he needed anything.
Gdje Pavle kaže Bog ne treba da ljudi služe njemu njegovim rukama kao da mu je nešto neophodno i potrebno od ljudi.
Because he himself gives all men life and breath and everything else.
Jer on svim ljudima daje život i dah i sve drugo.
And John Piper says that is not, it's not that, sorry, he says it's not that we shouldn't serve the Lord with gladness, the Bible says we should.
I Piper ne kaže da mi trebamo da mi ne trebamo da služimo Bogu dragovoljno. Biblija kaže da trebamo.
But we must understand God is not looking for people to work for him.
Ali moramo da razumemo, Bog ne gleda na ljude da rade za njega.
He is much more looking for people who let him work mightily in them.
On više gleda za ljudima u kojima će on da radi svojom silom.
So do you see the difference?
Da li vidite razliku?
It is one thing to say, I will work for God, I will work for God's kingdom.
Jedna stvar je reći, ja ću raditi za Boga, ja ću raditi za Božje carstvo.
It's another thing to say, I will humble myself.
A druga stvar je reći, ja ću poniziti sebe.
And I will allow God and his mighty power to work in me and through me.
Neka Bog i Božja sila rade u meni i kroz mene.
Here we might think of the Apostle Paul's testimony in 2 Corinthians chapter 12.
Možemo mi razmišljati i o Pavlovoj poruci u 2. Korinćanima 12. poglavlju.
There you will remember Paul pleaded and prayed with the Lord about a real weakness in his life.
Tamo je Pavle izneo i tražio Gospoda, prayed and pleaded.
He prayed about the weakness in his life. He asked God to.
Tražio od Gospoda te slabosti u svom životu. Tražio od njega da mu molio se za slabosti.
He talked about how he felt there was a thorn in his flesh.
Govorio je o trnu u svom mesu.
And he said, God, take it away, take my weakness, my pain away.
I tri put se molio da Gospod oduzme od njega taj bol.
And we do you remember God's answer?
I sećamo li se Božijeg odgovora?
The Lord's answer was this.
Božji odgovor je bio ovo.
My grace is sufficient for you.
Dovoljna ti je moja blagodat.
My power is made perfect in weakness.
My power.
Moja sila.
Power.
Slabosti,
my power. Yeah. Moja sila se pokazuje jače i bolje u slabosti.
So I urge you again, make your weakness available to God.
Tako da učinite vaše slabosti dostupne Gospodu.
So that his power can be shown in you and through you.
Tako da bi se njegova sila pokazala u vama i kroz vas.
And so that people who know you will see.
Tako da ljudi koji vas poznaju mogu da vide.
They will see God's all-surpassing power in your life.
Tako da će oni videti Božiju svemoguću silu i svemoguće delo u vama.
They will see that what makes you different.
Oni će videti da vas Bog čini drugačijima.
It's not just that you have some different kind of ideas.
Nije to što vi možda imate neke drugačije ideje.
But that God has radically changed your heart.
Nego je to Bog koji je radikalno promenio vaše srce.
God has made you a new person in Christ.
Bog je načinio od vas nove osobe u Hristu.
God has placed a new song in your mouth and new joy in your heart.
On je posejao nov radost u vaše srce.
Again, another famous missionary from the 19th century.
Pogledat ćemo i još jednog iz 19. veka misionara, njegovo razmišljanje.
And early 20th century.
Ili ranog 20. veka.
Hudson Taylor. He was a missionary to China.
On je bio misionar u Kini.
And he said this.
I rekao je ovo.
All God's giants have been weak men.
Svi Božiji divovi su bili slabi ljudi.
Weak men who did great things for God because they reckoned on God being with them.
Slabi ljudi koji su učinili velika dela za Gospoda jer su se oslonili na to da je Bog sa njima.
Finally, let me say this to you this morning.
Konačno, dozvolite mi da vam kažem ovo ovoga jutra.
As I say it to my own heart.
Kao što govorim i svom ličnom srcu.
Live with Jesus in the light of eternity.
Živi sa Isusom u svetlu večnosti.
The apostle Paul had many gifts.
Apostol Pavle je imao mnoge darove.
He had amazing endurance in gospel work.
Imao je izvanrednu izdržljivost u radu evanđelja.
But ultimately what mattered most to him was that he had the Lord Jesus.
Ali na kraju što mu je bilo najznačajnije i najvrednije jeste što je imao Gospoda Isusa Hrista.
He had the Son of God who would never leave him or forsake him.
Imao je Božijeg sina koji ga nikada neće napustiti niti ostaviti.
He had Jesus who was his savior.
Imao je Hrista koji je bio spasitelj.
His righteousness.
Njegova pravednost.
And his hope for eternity.
I njegova nada za večnost.
Here in 2 Corinthians 4, Paul speaks openly about the trials and the sufferings of gospel ministry.
Ovde u četvrtoj glavi Korinćanima druge poslanice Pavle govori o svoj patnji i o svim problemima u evanđelju.
But he has this confident assurance.
Ali ima ovo uvereno osiguranje, uverenu sigurnost.
We see it in verse 8.
Vidimo to u 8. stihu.
We are hard pressed on every side, but not crushed.
U svemu imamo nevolje, ali nam ne dosađuje.
Perplexed, but not in despair.
Zbunjeni smo, ali ne gubimo nadu.
Persecuted, but not abandoned.
Progone nas, ali nismo ostavljeni.
Struck down, but not destroyed.
Obaljuju nas, ali ne ginemo.
We always carry around in our body the death of Jesus.
Uvek na svojim telima nosimo smrt Hristovu.
So that the life of Jesus may also be revealed in our body.
Da se i život Isusov na telu našem pokaže.
And later in verse 16.
I kasnije u 16. stihu.
He concludes in this way.
Zaključuje na ovaj način.
Therefore we do not lose heart.
Zato nam se ne dosađuje.
Though outwardly we are wasting away.
No ako se naš spoljašnji čovjek i raspada,
yet inwardly we are being renewed day by day.
Ali se unutrašnji obnavlja svaki dan.
For our light and momentary troubles are achieving for us an eternal glory that far outweighs them all.
Tako da ona slava, naša laka sadašnja briga donosi nam večnu i od svega pretežniju slavu.
So we fix our eyes not on what is seen.
Tako da ne gledamo na ono što se vidi,
but on what is unseen.
Nego na ono što se ne vidi.
For what is seen is temporary.
Jer je ovo što se vidi za vreme.
What is unseen is eternal.
A ono što se ne vidi večno.
Like us, Paul was aware of how much things change as years pass.
Kao i mi, Pavle je bio svestan toga koliko se stvari menjaju kako vreme prolazi.
The strength and energy of youth passes all too quickly.
Snaga i energija mladosti prolazi veoma brzo.
The signs of middle age and old age begin to show.
Znakovi srednjeg doba i kasnog doba počinju da se pokazuju.
Our hair grows gray, turns gray.
Naša kosa se pretvara u sivu kosu.
For some of us our hair just disappears.
Za neke od nas naša kosa samo nestaje.
But
ali
even if our skin is wrinkled,
čak i ako nam je koža smežurana,
our hair is gray,
kosa siva,
our bodies are susceptible to illness,
tela su nam podložna bolesti,
they don't work the way they used to,
ne rade kao što su radila.
In that way it's outwardly we are wasting away.
Tako da spoljašnje gledano mi polako nestajemo.
But for a Christian who is going on with the Lord year after year.
Ali za hrišćanina koji ide za Gospodom godinu za godinom.
Living in the power of the Holy Spirit.
Živeći u zajednici sa Duhom Svetim.
That Christian will continually be bearing new spiritual fruit.
Taj hrišćanin će i dalje donositi nov duhovni rod.
And as they immerse themselves in the truth of God's word.
Dok se posvećuje istinama Svetoga pisma.
They will become all the firmer and all the stronger in their faith.
Biće mu sve više potvrđeni i sve više jače u njegovom biću.
Inwardly, as Paul says, we will be renewed day by day.
Unutra mi ćemo biti obnovljeni dan za danom, iz dana u dan.
Our spiritual strength, our confidence in God can grow.
Naša duhovna snaga, naše poverenje u Gospoda, oslanjanje na Gospoda će rasti.
Even as at the same time our physical strength might be declining.
Iako u isto vrijeme naša fizička snaga će polako nestajati.
What keeps Paul pressing on, he says, is the great weight of eternal glory.
Šta drži Pavla da nastavlja jeste slavno iščekivanje večne slave.
He expects the glory of God to be his final reward and something to be enjoyed forever.
On očekuje Bog da bude njegova finalna nagrada i radost da bude zauvek.
I don't know what's happening in anyone's life here today.
Ne znam šta se dešava u vašim životima ovdje danas.
Sometimes our lives involve great difficulty and pressure.
Nekada naši životi se suočavaju sa velikim pritiskom i velikim poteškoćama.
Sometimes we battle with things we can hardly endure.
Nekada se borimo sa nekim stvarima koje je jako teško da izdržimo.
But if those things are weighing us down now.
Ali ako nas ove stvari opterećuju sada.
We who believe in Jesus Christ as Lord and Savior.
Mi koji vjerujemo u Isusa Hrista kao Spasitelja i Gospoda.
Know that the glory of God and of heaven that's ahead of us surpasses it all.
Znajući da je slava i veličanstvo neba ispred nas, to prevazilazi sve.
I think it's unusual how Paul describes his troubles as light and momentary.
Neobičajeno kako Pavle objašnjava svoj život and light prosvetljen.
Light and passing, short-lived, light and short-lived. Yeah.
Život koji je kratak i koji prolazi.
Because that's not how trouble sometimes feels.
Ne osjećamo se često da tako problemi, tako sa problemima, da prolaze baš.
If we think about what Paul says in chapter 11 of 2 Corinthians.
Ako razmišljamo o tome što Pavle kaže u 11. poglavlju druge Korinćanima.
There he talks about his experience of being severely beaten.
Tu priča o svom iskustvu kako je bio užasno prebijen.
Being exposed to death again and again.
Bio izložen smrti iznova i iznova.
And being stoned and being shipwrecked.
Čak je bio kamenovan i bio je u brodolomu.
Those things do not sound like light short-lived trouble.
To uopšte ne izgleda kao da je kratkotrajna muka.
But compared to the eternal glory and eternal pleasure of heaven.
Ali kada se to uporedi sa večnom slavom i večnim zadovoljstvom u nebu.
Even those painful and difficult things are passing away.
Čak i te bolne i teške stvari prolaze.
Paul looked at life in such a different way than we sometimes do.
Pavle gledao u život na tako drugačiji način nego što mi nekada gledamo.
But he looked simply through the eyes of faith.
Ali on uvek jednostavno gledao kroz oči vere.
And he says this is what should be the necessary experience of every Christian.
I kazao je ovo što bi trebao da bude neophodno iskustvo svakog hrišćanina.
These words in verse 18.
Ove reči u stihu 18.
We fix our eyes not on what is seen, but what is unseen.
Nismo postavili svoje oči, nismo uperili svoje oči na ono što se vidi, nego na ono što se ne vidi.
Because what is seen,
jer zato što je ono što se vidi,
that's all of the trouble and all of the difficulty,
sve muke i svi problemi,
it is temporary.
To je privremeno.
But what is unseen,
ali ono što se ne vidi,
the glory of God's presence,
slava Božijeg prisustva,
is eternal.
To je večno.
May God grant each one of us that hope and that vision.
Neka nam Bog podari svakome od nas tu nadu i tu viziju.
Amen.
Amen.